Come on, come on, come on. We got a sweet liquor, we got our pajamas.
Oh, Yes, Lord, we worship you. In your holiness, we give you all the praises, oh God. We give you all the praises, oh God. We thank you, glorious
Savior. Imani da saza, imani da chena, imani da chiki neke. Dio tu ramia.
Thank you. hearts to praise the Lord.
Because this is the mitzvah I have to pray every month.
He never grows old.
Davidi chiki
hevi. He's never poor.
Davidi chena.
And he's never discouraged.
Davidi chiki hevi.
I don't know what you're waiting for today.
Since you didn't want to come with us.
I don't know what fire or river you're crossing.
Sinzi aho uri kunyura hatoroshye ariko ijambo riracyashoboye imana iracyashoboye kandi imana niyo kwizerwa data mu izina rya yesu duhe ahayimana duhaye izina ryawe icyubahiro ijambo ryawe riravuga ngo hahirwe ishyanga kandi hahirwe ubwoko bufiteho imana uwiteka mwami turagushima ko tugufite nk'imana yacu nka data niyo mpamvu twibagiwe ibirimo kuduca intege byose tukibanza ku kuramya gusa reka mwami kuramya kwacu kuzamuke kukugereho reka tukuzamurire amaboko nk'igitambo kizima urakoze data kukudukunda kandi gukomera kwawe urakoze data icyubahiro cyose kikugarukire mu izina rya yesu
turabashimiye tubabakiriye muri aya materaniro
rwose
turacyari kumwe
Even those that are following us on live streaming, we welcome you to this morning service.
N'abatukurikira online tubakiriye muri aya materaniro.
The Lord is good.
Imana ni nziza.
Even this morning, the Lord is good.
N'iki gitondo Imana ni nziza.
And He is still faithful.
Kandi iracyari yo kwizerwa.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
We thank the Lord that we ended the third week. In our 40 days of fasting and prayer.
Turashimana ko dusoje icyumweru cyacu cya gatatu cyo kwiriza no gusenga.
And we remind us that the main theme is transforming us in Christ's likeness.
Kandi turibukiranya yuko icyo turimo kwibandaho ari uguhindurwa gusa na Yesu.
The third week is gone.
Icyumweru cya gatatu kirashize.
The 11th month is gone.
Kandi no kwa cumi na kumwe kuriho kurarangira sinzi ibyawe ariko ngeyo nisuzuma ndacyakeneye guhindurwa hari ibiti biteye ambutayaje muri jyewe haracyarimo intambara
We need the Lord to transform us.
Dukeneye Imana kuduhindura.
In His likeness.
Tugasa na yo.
Lord, may you please help us in a short prayer.
Reka dusabe gato yadufashe mu isengesho rito.
We do not want to cross over to 2016.
Ntabwo dushaka kujya muri 2016.
When we still have the chance. Transformation is Christian life, but there is a purpose why God gave His servant this theme this year.
Guhindurwa n'ubuzima bw'umukristo ariko hari impamvu Imana yahaye uwo mutwe w'uyu mwaka umukozi wayo. Let's hold hands. The prayer request is one that we are going to share.
the one
who transforms us is the one, is only one.
Jesus, no God, sure.
And he is able.
Jesus, no God, you don't know the name.
The good thing is that he is able of what is a problem for us. The good news is that this morning can be a good beginning for you. And good thing is that we need it and we want it. Let's draw close to God.
Samuel, how I saw her. I call a boy. We look at Luqua. In Baraka, you don't need sound. We say yes. We say yes. We say yes. We say yes. Natangaza ubwenge bushya, natangaza imitekerereze mishya, natangaza
ndotosha ndatanga zishakarisha ndatangaza inyotasha ndatangaza izarasha izara y'Imana muri twebwe kutuma kafale prapata shakereba boshigiri lakati rumba paka shata leba farema shiaba kutulule rumba paka pata la proku papayebo. Hari imbaraga iki gitondo zishobora guhindura amateka yawe. Hari imbaraga zivana mu buretwa. Hari imbaraga zivana mu ngoyi. Hari imbaraga zivana muri kamere. Hari imbaraga zireba.
Pastor Patrick Masasu. And I walked away with one thing.
Kandi najyanye ikintu kimwe.
Renouncing.
Kurekura.
There are so many that we had, but I think everybody took one thing.
Hari byinshi twumvise ngira ngo buri muntu hari icyo yakuyemo.
Kutagundira ibyo byose bitubuza to be transformed.
Renouncing all that is holding us to be transformed.
Servant of the Lord, we appreciate you.
Mukozi w'Imana turagushimiye.
And we welcome.
Kandi turabakiriye.
May we all rise and welcome the man of God.
Katuhaguruke twakire ijambo ry'Imana n'umukozi wayo.
Murakoze reka twicare.
Reka worship protocol badufashe dutanga amaturo pastor arimo kuduha introduction.
Let the ushers help us as we give our offerings.
We greet
you again in the name of Jesus Christ.
We are
happy to be with you this morning.
We started
Sunday evening.
On
Monday we
are here. On Tuesday and
throughout the week up to Friday.
And we have another night
on Friday here.
Ejo ashize kwa gatandatu twari turi hano
Saturday yesterday we are here
kandi iki gitondo turi gusoza icyumweru cyacu.
And this morning we are concluding our week.
Iki gitondo nazanye n'umuryango wanjye wose.
This morning my entire family came with me.
Nazanye na madame n'abana,
his wife and the children.
Can they
please come forward?
Reka madamu nawe abaramutse.
Hallelujah. 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 Are we there this morning?
Siri turi kumwe iki gitondo.
Hallelujah. We are so humbled to be
here.
We have been blessed this week. Hallelujah. We are honored.
Kandi ubyukuri bitute iteka.
Stand on this pulpit, on our father's
pulpit.
Hallelujah. Amen. We love you so much. And
we
are so proud.
Kandi
turabishimira.
Hallelujah. We love our daddy
so much. Amen. And we love you too.
And I know that you have
been also blessed by Pastor Patrick.
Amen. And we are
so I don't have enough to say, but I praise God. Let's pray.
And stand up and pray. Father, we
thank
you. We praise
you.
You know
everything.
You love us so much.
Thank
you,
Papa.
This
morning,
tondo,
we humble
ourselves
to hear from you.
Kugirango tukumve, tukumve.
Touch our hearts.
Kora ku
and our spirit.
We
really want to be transformed.
We
really want to change for good.
And
to look like you,
O
Jesus. Bless everyone. Anoint again your servant. In the name of
Jesus
Christ.
Amen. Watangiye kuva ku cyumweru nimugoroba tuvuga ijuru yo guhindurwa gusa na Yesu Kristo. Twavuze ibintu byinshi mu by'ukuri iminsi irindwi aba ari iminsi myinshi kandi amagambo avuzwe ni menshi. Ayo magambo ni menshi ntabwo nabasha kuyarondora yose kugira ngo ngere ku cyo nshaka gukora iki gitondo. Ariko kugira ngo mbashe kugera ku cyo nifuza ko tuganira iki gitondo, twavuze yuko guhinduka n'intego y'agakiza kacu. Hanyuma tuza kugeraho tureba imiyoboro y'impinduka. Imiyoboro y'impinduka Imana ijye kuduhindura ikoresha izihe nzira wowe buryo.
God is about to transform us, what are the ways that he uses?
Babonye inzira zitandukanye.
We
so different ways. Kandi yambere twavuze yuko ni bwa busabane bw'imitse n'Imana.
And the first one we mentioned was the true fellowship with God.
Inzira yo busabane n'Imana.
The fellowship, the way of the fellowship with God.
A personal encounter with the Lord. Busabana mu buryo bw'imitse n'Imana.
A personal encounter with God.
Iyo ni muyoboro umwe Imana ikoresha mu kuduhindura.
This is one of the channels that God uses to change us.
Twavuze yuko urije uzasa n'usabana nawe.
We said that you will be looking like the one you spend time with.
Paul aravuga ngo burya inshuti mbi zonona ingeso nziza.
Paul said that bad friendship are destroying the good habits.
Kubera yuko kenshi ko musabana hari ikintu gikore kibita guhererekanya imyuka.
When you fellowship, when you stay with someone, there is an exchange of spirits.
Nero niyo mpamvu nanone iyo usabanye n'Imana Imana ikwanduza irabuhindura igutereramo akamero kayo.
That's why when we dwell long enough with God, God contaminates you, God pushes to you his nature.
Ubu busabane turi kuvuga ntabwo ari amasengesho tukora no mu minota 10 munota 5 no ntabwo ari ayo ngayo.
The fellowship we mean there is not prayers of 5 minutes or 10 minutes, it's not about that one.
Ni kuvuga gufata umwanya umwihariko wo gusabana mu buryo bw'imitse n'Imana.
I speak about the special time when you spend time, you dwell before God for long enough.
Iyo twifashe iminsi ibiri, itatu, ine, 21, 40, tukareka byose tugasabana mu buryo bw'imitse n'Imana.
When we spend time 2 days, 3 days, 4 days a week, 20 or 40 days, and we spend time with God, having abandoned every other thing.
Ubu buryo bwo gusabana muri ubu buryo nibwo buduhindura ubuzima bwacu.
Such a time, that's the one that changes deeply our life.
Urebe ubuzima bwa Yakobo.
Look at the life of Jacob.
Yakobo amaze kuriganya mukuru we aragenda.
Jacob has stolen from his brother and he's running.
Munsi buzima bwe kwa Labani bwari buzima mu buryo bukubitika yarakubititsemo iyo yagiye.
You know the life that he spent at Laban's house was a very hard life. He had a very tough life.
Ariko agaruka hari ikintu cyabaye.
But when he was coming back, there's something that happened.
Bibiliya avuga ngo yambutsa abagore be bombi n'abana n'ibye byose abyambutsa umugezi we asigara hakuno y'umugezi wenyine.
The Bible says that he sent his wife and the children and stayed behind alone.
Asigaye wenyine akirana n'umumarayika w'Uwiteka ayinjira muri encounter with the Lord.
When he stayed alone, that's when he had a special encounter with God.
Hanyuma
umfitabaye. And look what happened.
Abwira Imana ndashaka umugisha.
And he told God, I want to be blessed.
Umugisha.
Give me blessing.
Imana yamubaza ngo witwa nde?
And God asked him, what's your name?
Reka nkubwire, umugisha wawe uzajyanirana buri gihe n'urwego ugezemo mu guhinduka.
The blessing that you have will go hand in hand with your level of being transformed.
Kandi imwe mu miyoboro Imana ikoresha ni bwa busabane bw'imitsi yawe usigarana nawe wenyine.
And some of the ways that God uses that encounter, the special encounter that you have with him.
Aravuga ngo umugisha.
And say, give me blessing.
Amareka namubwira witwa nde?
And the angel say, who's your name?
Igihe we yashakaga imigisha.
When he was looking for blessing.
Imana yashakaga kumuhindura.
God wanted to change him.
Kuko umugisha buri gihe ujyanirana n'urwego rw'impinduka yawe.
Because the blessing goes with the level of your transformation.
Hari imigisha Imana itashaka kuguha uyu munsi kubera yuko ari urwego rw'impinduka runaka utarageramo.
There are some blessings that God can push to you because you've not yet been transformed enough.
Kuko iramutse ibiguhaye iyo migisha yakwica.
Because if he gives you such blessing, those blessings will kill your life.
Maze abwira malaika mumugisha, malaika arambwira hoya witwa nde?
And the angel of the Lord say, what's your name? When he asked,
maze aravuga ngo nitwa Yakobo.
And he said, my name is Jacob.
Arambwira okay, guhera uyu munsi.
And he said, from today,
ntabwo uzongera kwitwa Yakobo.
You will not be called Jacob anymore.
Uzitwa Israel.
You will be called Israel.
Urebe guhera uwo munsi nibwo ibintu byatangiye kwikoreka mu buryo butangaje mu buzima bwa Yakobo.
And if you can see from that day, that's the day when things start to change in the life of Jacob.
Reba umuntu wari warahawe umugisha warambitsweho ibiganza na se ariko uwo mugisha ntabwo watembaga ni gute wajya gukorera kugira ngo ubone umugore ubone n'impamba imyaka 21 uwo muntu wahawe umugisha.
You see, he received the blessing from his father, but the blessing was not yet activated in his life. How can you see? He worked for so many years to get one wife.
Urabizi umukozi w'Imana yanakuramika ibiganza akanatura amagambo. It's fine.
The man of God can hand and lay his hand on you. It's good.
ariko buri gihe uburyo bwo gutemba bwo mugisha bujyanirana buri gihe n'urwego rwo guhinduka kwawe
Jacobo
yarakubititse imyaka 21 ubwo buzima nge simbona umugisha wari urimo kuko mu gicu hari ikintu cyari kitarakoreka kiminduka ku buzima bwe
The heavenly realm, but something that has not yet happened in his life.
Ariko amaze guhindurwa.
After his change.
Aba Yakobo. Aba Israel.
After his transformation into Israel.
Icyambere asanganira mukuru we. Bisangaho nta kibazo na kimwe cyabaye.
The first thing he met his brother, and for the brother it was if there was no real problem.
Hanyuma ibintu bitangira kwikora.
And things had to happen.
Bitangira kwikora mu buzima bwe.
Things had to happen in his life.
Imana igiye ikora ibintu bitangaje. Reka nkubwire yuko ukeneye gushaka umwanya wo gusabana n'Imana mu buryo bw'imiti.
Icyo
Satani ari gukora ari kukubeshya yuko uri bizi nta mwanya ufite. Kandi uko urushaho kuba bizi ni nako urushaho gutindira guhinduka. Uko utindira guhinduka nako utindira imigisha yawe.
Shaka
umwanya ushaka Imana.
Find time to search God.
Nubwo waba uri umukozi.
Even if you are working.
Ariko mu mwaka ugira konje.
But in the year you have to leave.
Iyo dufate za konje abakozi twebwe dusanzwe.
When you have to leave what we do.
Dutekereza nsohokane n'umugore wanjye n'abana banjye ngende fata akayaga nduhuke. Ariko ntabwo dutekereza yuko Imana nayo irashaka ko dusabana.
You find time for a while you go on vacation on holiday on the beach but you don't remember that even God is yearning to meet you.
Umuyoboro wa kabiri.
Second channel.
Twavuze by suffering mbese ku mibabaro. Imana ikoresha inzira y'imibabaro. Ijambo dufite hariya ni Abaheburayo igice cya 5:8. Biratubwira ngo nyamara nubwo yari umwana w'Imana yigishijwe kumvira ku bw'imibabaro yihanganye. Urabizi iki kintu cyo gukwepa ishuri ry'Imana kiravuna abantu benshi n'impamvu benshi badahinduka. Imana ikoresha ibihe bikomeye ikoresha harimo ibibabaro kugira ngo iduhindure.
Reka
nguhe urugero. Ntabwo wavuga ngo uri umuntu uzi kwihangana ikibazo kitaragukindira.
You cannot say that you have long suffering when you never got any problem in your life.
Ntabwo wavuga ngo njyewe rwose murabizi ngemba ndi umuntu uzi kwihangana cyane.
You cannot say that I'm a very patient person.
Kugira ngo bimenyekane ko iyo ndangagaciro yo kwihangana ufite muri wowe hagomba kuba ikibazo kigutindira kikugora kikukanda. Icyo gihe ni bwo wamenya ngo burya uri umuntu uzi kwihangana cyangwa ntabwo iyo ndangagaciro irafata umwanya mu buzima bwawe. Hari ibintu Imana icyaza mu buzima bwacu izi ndangagaciro za kamero kayo Imana ikoresha umuyoboro w'akababaro. Urabizi itandukaniro hagati y'umwami Sawuli na mwami Dawidi nta kindi buryo.
King Saul and the King David.
Umwe yari umuntu wanyuze mu ishuri
ry'Imana. One went to the class of God, the school of God.
Undi ntabwo yanyuze mu ishuri ry'Imana.
The other one taught that school.
Ureberere umusaruro bombi batanze ukungana.
And then look at the harvest of each one of them brought.
Dawidi yanyuze mu ishuri ry'Uwiteka.
David went to the school of God.
Burya Sawuli yasaga na Adamu wa mbere.
Saul was looking at the first Adam.
Maze Dawidi agasa na Adamu wa kabiri. Urabizi itandukaniro hagati ya Adamu wa mbere n'uwa kabiri. Adamu wa mbere yavutse ayobora. Yavutse ari umugabo. Avuka ategeka. Ntabwo yanyuze muri process runaka y'ishuri yo kwiga yo kwitoza ya development nayo yanyuzemo. Rero kubera ibyo ngibyo bituma na none hari ibintu atashoboye kwihanganira. Niyo mpamvu mubona Imana igiye kohereza Adamu wa kabiri kugira ngo akosore ibyo Adamu wa mbere yishe.
Yanze
yuko Adamu wa kabiri aza atanyuze muri prosesi yose y'imikurire ndetse n'inzira ikwiriye.
process of growth and all the entire process.
Avuke umwana.
Let him be born as a child.
Akira ababyeyi.
Have parents.
Yige kumvira.
Learn to obey.
Yige kuganduka.
Learn to obey.
Ahanwe.
Be corrected. Sometimes they even scold
him.
Until he becomes a real man. And then God starts using him. But the first Adam did not go through that process. That's why you see Jesus Christ. The temptation that Adam had of the lust of the eyes and the body. That's made the first Adam fall, Jesus Christ overcame them. The school of God that we have when we are suffering builds in us the values of God. And many of us run away from the school of God. That's why you see that David was never trying to do a single thing by himself to get out of that school.
No.
They will tell him, look, Saul is here, we can kill him and everything is finished. And he said, no. Let God take care of
him.
God will. He knew he was in the school of God. And he had to finish that school the same way God
did.
There's no shortcut that we need to take. Today, many people, they have many prayer requests that are not even good prayer requests
for the
Lord. There are many things that we have in our lives because we run away from the school of God. And now you find yourself one day, because when you dodge it, it still comes back. You have now a problem and you have to pray. And when you start to pray, God looks at you
and
says, my son, up to now you've never asked. Now you've been praying, but you've not yet asked. Because what you're telling me is not a prayer
request.
I'm not saying your prayer
request.
Say, Pastor, what are you saying?
Abraham,
his wife told him this.
Be
with this servant of ours and then we'll have a child. And they got a child. And then the child was born. When the child was born, Isaac was born from the
mother.
And then the wife said, this mother and the child, they need to go. And then Sarah went back to Abraham and said, I want this woman and the child to go. And now Abraham brought a prayer request.
Mana.
What do you say about this thing? My wife is great. My wife is great. You know what God said?
Go back there.
This problem, when you started it, you didn't involve me, you go back. For me, it's not a prayer request. What do you want me to do? When you obeyed her and have this child, you've been used to listen to her. Go listen to her now.
So sometimes,
in our lives, that's how it goes. You see someone has dodged the trust of God. God is teaching you, is making you pass through a factory so that you
can go.
And you say, oh, I cannot stay in this thing, and you pass
through.
You know, when you do that, you are doing bad to yourself. I gave an example of a girl. She's being brought up in a family. She's
an
orphan. And in that place, they're not picking her the same way her parents
would have.
These are things that are possible in this society.
So, well.
And in that place, she should not be happy
with it.
And when she lacks that happiness, instead of her knowing that God is training her
in faith,
learn patience, and learn obedience, and learning to long suffering and without
pain,
and developing an endurance that will make you go through.
Because
the people that God needs to trust. Some people who just run away any minute. And when that girl does not learn
this,
she finished school, she gets some money.
And
here
is
nice. I'm out of this place. And she goes in the home. And she lives alone. She ran the school, and now she starts alive. And in the home where she is, and she gets born again, and she comes in church. And after coming in church, there's a brother who saw her.
She's
a good
girl.
And there's a wedding. When is the wedding? They go home. In that home, let me tell you what is the home. Home,
nubuzima,
is a life.
Kura buri munsi
is a life where you let
go ubere ho mugenzi wawe,
so that you may live for your friend.
Ubere yuko umwana w'umukobwa tigeze abyigira hano kurekura no kwihanganira ibintu no kuberaho aba mutegeka cyangwa se abamuyobora.
Because she never took the time to learn in that home setup where she had to let go of everything.
Hano mu rugo ntabwo azabishobora.
In this new home of hers, there'll be a problem.
Njyewe bingibi njyewe urugo rwawe n'umugabo wanjye n'umugore wanjye.
It's not okay. Then she goes back to God.
Pastor,
my husband,
is not
my wife,
my
wife,
we can't agree,
things are not going to God. This is not a prayer request.
It's a promise to fix character.
Before God, those are values that she was supposed to have received before that she didn't take.
No, no, we are equipped. Bitanje kumugora mu buzima igihe akagombe kunezererwa ubuzima.
She avoided them, and then now she's paying the price because she was supposed to be happy now.
Uko niko abantu benshi
bagendekera. This is how it happens to many people.
Ndakwinginze nukwepe ishuri ryima.
Please don't run away from the school of God.
Hari ryima ni kuha umushefu kazi ukarike cyane.
There are times God gives you a boss at work who's just very tough.
Hari ryima ni kumushumba uri very tough.
There are times God gives you a pastor who is very tough. There are times God puts you in a situation that is really hard and you are pressured. There are times God can put you somewhere and no one understands your problem. That's what I ask you, please never run away, never avoid the school of God. Because those schools change our character and give us values that are required to live godly lives. The third path. The third path God uses. And this is where I'm
going to say discipleship.
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 Is a path that God uses to change our lives. Discipleship itself is transformation. When you read in Matthew 4, Jesus said to Peter, follow me. Follow me and I'll transform you, fishermen of men.
Fishermen.
We're not going to talk about transformation without speaking about
discipleship.
You see, we've been talking about discipleship these 7 years, and now we are talking about transformation. In other words, a
transformation.
It's
one of the signs that show a true disciple. And the discipleship itself is one of the paths that transforms us. I'm saying that transformation and discipleship have a connection.
That
has used the discipleship path to transform our
lives.
Jesus Christ said it when he was starting his journey with the
disciples.
Follow me and I'll transform you, fisher of men. We cannot talk about discipleship that you are a disciple and you abandon being transformed. Another scripture. In Acts of Apostles,
11:26,
the Bible says, and the disciples were first called Christians in Antioch. They did not call any person Christians. They called the disciples. Because a disciple is the only one in whom you see the values of Christ. If God is about to put in you the values of Christ, it prepares the path of disciples. Another scripture. In Acts 4:13, when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were uneducated and untrained men, they
marveled.
So then they realized that they had been with Jesus. Who were John and Peter? Because those are the people that they looked and they saw that they had the character of
Christ.
John and Peter were not just people who were passing by, they were people dwelling and being discipled by Jesus Christ.
They
knew them as just normal people, fishermen who were not educated, but they saw the character of Christ in them because Christ spent time with them. And they were marveled. And they saw that they have boldness. And they realized that these people spent time with Jesus Christ. We spoke about the three group of people who are in the church. There are three categories of people that you can identify wherever Christ
is.
Whenever you read in the scripture, you find these three categories. You see the first category is the crowd. Or the mass.
And
other places you find the believers. And then you find another place where they speak about the disciples. There are three categories. Those are the three categories you find wherever Christ was. Let's go to the first one. The first one is the crowd of the mass of people. These people are characterized by instability. In those scriptures you find there, they'll just change the way the time will change. They flow with whatever way the waters are flowing. They sang Hosanna for Jesus, Hosanna, Hosanna,
Hosanna.
And a few minutes after they say, crucify him, crucify him, crucify
him.
And these groups do not depend on the time, the years you spend in church.
This
category is depend on how your thinking patterns are.
Ushobora kubumaza imyaka 5 10 mu itoro ariko uracyabarizwa mu mitekerezo n'imyifatire yawe mu mbaga.
You may have spent years in the church but in your mind you are still in the crowd.
Aba ni abantu batagira umusimamo wa mugana baswahili.
These are the people who don't foundations.
N'abantu batashobora gushika mahamwe ngo barangize inshingano.
They can't stand in this place and finish all they had to do.
N'abantu bazanwaga n'impamvu zitandukanye kusanga Yesu.
They were brought with many different reasons to find
Jesus.
Some would come just to watch or to accompany others.
Abandi bazaga kubera ikigari gusata buri migati bakaza.
Some were just want to see the bread, the miracles.
Abandi bazaga kubera gusa yuko bumvishe ko Yesu Kristo aje aho ngaho hafi yabo nabo bakaza.
And others because they've heard that Jesus Christ in the vicinity and they just come.
Abana abantu Yesu Kristo atizera.
Those are the people Christ does not trust. He doesn't trust that they can really follow what he has to do. But there are things that Christ do for these people so that they get changed and get out of the group. What he does, he gives them the word, the good news. So that they may hear and they may have faith. Because when they get faith, they become believers. And the Bible tells us, how will they get born again without faith? How will they believe if they didn't hear? How will they hear if there's no one who preaches or speaks the word? So that they speak, they need someone who goes. There's nothing that takes someone from the crowd, it's the word of God. This is the first category. Second one,
Nabizera.
The believers.
Abizera ni babandi bavuye mu mbaga mu mbaraga z'ijambo ryabwirizwe bakizera.
The believers are those that have gone out of the crowd and they now
believe.
And those one, even if they believe Christ,
Kristo nago abayiba bizera.
Christ does not trust them yet.
Nago ababa baragera mu rwego habizera we.
They are not yet in a level where Christ can trust them.
Imamvu atabizera kuko n'abadayimo n'abarizera ndetse baranatitira.
The reason why it doesn't trust them because even the demons believe and they're even shaking.
Ndashaka yukusobanukira iki kintu neza.
I want you to understand this.
Imana idukunda twese kimwe nago twizera twese kimwe.
God loves us all the same but it does not trust us all the same.
Nuko nawe nago wizera buri muntu wese uhuye nawe nubwo mwaba mwahuye.
The same as you don't trust any person you meet every day.
Kizere ni kintu umuntu akorera kifata igihe.
The trust is something that you need to work for. It takes time.
Nikintu bubaka.
It's something that is built.
Aba bantu babizera.
Those believers.
Nubwo bashobora kuba barizeye Kristo.
Even if they've already believed Christ.
Ariko Kristo we nago ababizera.
Christ does not trust them yet.
Bibiliya yuzemo abizera benshi.
The Bible is full of believers.
Harabari imigati.
Those ate breads. Some got healed of disease.
Harabakize ibibembe.
Some got healed of leprosy. Some people had serious problems and Jesus solved them. And Jesus used to say, your faith has saved you. Even if Jesus was saying your faith has saved you, I've seen faith in you, that's why you received this miracle. But there's no place we see Christ continuing a story with them. The story finished there. There's one scripture that you see. John 2. They learned that Jesus did the miracle. And they followed him believing him. But he did not rely on them because he knew them. Even if they believed in him. Let me tell you. God moves with those he trusts. In this group is good. But it's one of the steps. There's another level where Christ will trust you.
We
work with Christ. And that is the discipleship level. The
the third group is the disciples. The disciples, the disciples of Christ, is someone who believed, who took the decision to follow Christ and to become like him, to look like him. You can't be a disciple if you've not yet been a believer. You first start in the crowds. That is where Christ found all of us. When we heard the word of God, we became believers. Because you believed him, you received him, he gave them the right to become children of God. And when you are when you become a believer, there's a decision. There's something, there's a focus. And you fight for that focus, which is to look like Christ. And that process to look and become like Christ, that's the one we call the discipleship process. In Luke 5, the Bible gives us a good news. I want to give you an example of someone who was in the crowd and became a disciple. Jesus went to Genezareth. When he got there, and he found himself with many people. He had many people around him. There was a crowd around him. And he asked someone to give him a boat. Just look in that scripture, this image I gave you.
For Christ to remove people from the crowd and give them the believer level is preach the word. He sat in the boat and preached. After he finished, he told the owner of the boat, let's go again in deep waters. They went in deep waters. When they reached there, he told him this: throw your net here. Look at what this man said. Lord, me, I worked the entire night. But because of your words, because I trust in you, because I've known you, I'm going to do it. Peter was like the crowd. Jesus found him in the same level of the crowd. He was one of that category. But because of the good news that he received, he reached a level where he trusted Jesus Christ, and he became a believer. He heard the word of Christ, obeyed the word of Christ,
lived
in Christ. He accepted the
question,
but it was not all. When he got so many fish, in 11, the
Bible,
when they reached at the shore, he dropped everything. And he followed Jesus Christ. That is where discipleship started. The problem is that many people stopped and parked in the believer level. I used to drink, I'm not drinking anymore. I spend my time in the bar, now I just go home at church. I used to be a womanizer. Now I trust Jesus, I believe in Jesus. But this is not enough. The power of Christianity and the sweetness of Christianity and the benefit of Christianity is not in the believer stage. It's not among the believers. It's among the disciples. In the disciples. And those are the one Christ trusts. Those are the one Christ invests in. Those are the one Christ watches. Those are the one that are partners with Christ. The power of Christ is not in the believer level. The one who had a disease for 12 years, she was saved, she got healed at this level of believers, and after that she went her way and Christ went his way. The one who was sick for 38 years when he was healed, he went this way and Christ went the other way.
Kwizera Yesu Kristo nago bizamutera kukwizera.
Believing Jesus Christ will not push Christ to trust
you. Even
the demons, they believe him and they know him even
more. They
just not believe, they even shake whenever they hear about him.
Christ wants the
disciples
where
he can trust, those in whom he can invest, he may look at those who want to speak like him, those who want to work,
and
if you are a believer, get out of that and start looking
like him.
That is where the power and the benefits of Christianity is. Some people think getting out of the crowd, become a believer, that's sufficient. I sing at church, I work for God, I pray. I'm an intercessor. But let me tell you, this topic of this year 2015, there is a secret of discipleship. In that scripture, that's where everything is hidden.
Aho,
there. What's the reason why you don't have many disciples? Even if all of us know it's important to get there, because it asks for a price. There's a price to be a disciple. And here's the price. Next slide. There's a cost to pay. And here it is. Is to deny yourself. To deny yourself. To renounce about yourself. There's a barrier that you walk with the cross. And you follow him. That's why you see many people fail. That's why you see people wanting it, but they stop. Because there is a price. Let me tell you this. We were saved by faith. But don't become disciples just by
faith.
Let me repeat that statement. We've been saved by grace. But we don't be transformed in disciples just by grace. There is a price to pay. There is a price to pay. There is a price to pay. To renounce yourself, the price to let it go, the price to carry your cross and follow Christ. That's why many people fail. But let me not scare you. Whatever requires a price gives you a benefit. It also gives you a benefit. Don't fear the price. There's also benefits. Let me tell you the benefits. When you accept to become a disciple, there are many benefits. Anything that costs you also have a benefit. The first benefit. Christ revealed his secret to his disciples only. Revelation is the food of disciples. The revelation or the secrets of the kingdom are the food for the disciples. In that scripture, we see a disciple. A proverb or...
It's just a story that Jesus
story
was
that
sharing
Jesus
with
people. And when he finished that story, he went in a separate place. Then he gave the explanation to his disciples. And he even told them, you, for you got the rights. For you, it is your rights. This is your benefit. This is what I give you. This is your inheritance.
The secrets of the kingdom. And continue talking to them in stories. They have ears, but they don't understand. They have eyes, but they don't see. But for you, you need to know my things. The second benefit.
Only disciples of Christ can be anointed.
Christ
does not anoint the believers.
No.
That's not how it works.
So my Bible is
read properly your Bible. Christ will not anoint the believers. Because the anointing of the Holy Spirit is so precious. You give that to those he trusts, those are the disciples. Just so you see, there are things that we don't manage to do. Even if you believe in Christ.
Let me
show you. There's a scripture we all read. Look at the sign that will follow those who believe.
Let me show you.
But who was Christ saying these words to? Was it the crowd, the believers, or the disciples? Look at the scripture. In my name, they will put their hands on the sick and they'll be healed. They'll chase out the demons. But who was Christ addressing? Who was Christ talking to in Mark 16? He was saying goodbye to his trustees. He was saying goodbye to the disciples. He was giving a last word to his disciples. Because you believed in me, you. Because you believe me, you, the disciples, look at what you follow you.
No!
These were not the believers who came to get healed.
No!
He didn't say those words to the crowd. Even if he spent time with all this category of people, but he never told them this type of words. And that's why we say, we chase away diamond. The demon say, who are you? The children of Shepherd. They went to chase demons. In the name of Jesus Christ that Paul is preaching. And the demon said, Paul, you mentioned we know him.
No, yes, Mufuka.
Even that Jesus. Even you, you don't even know him. We know him very well. Even more than you. Now, who are you?
Oh,
we are talking in the name of Jesus.
Oh yeah,
I say
Paul, Mufuka, Turamuzi.
Paul, I know.
Na yes, Mufuka, Turamuzi.
Even Jesus, we know. But who are you? We don't know you. There's some problems that require anointing in your life. There's a problem that requires anointing. And that anointing will break the yoke. That anointing is for the disciples. Those are the ones who receive the Holy Spirit. He said, don't leave this room. Stay in this city. There's something. I'm going to send you a helper. What I've done, I've done. But I had this last thing. There's something. There's something. He was not talking to the crowd. He was talking to the believers. He was talking to Ababa the disciples, those who dwelt in, those who paid the price, those who followed him, those who denied themselves, those who took their cross, those who have beaten him, those who
stepped
on him. Those are the ones he trusts. Those are the ones he dresses.
Kyagatatu. Kyagatatu nuko Kristo ayishura ubwiza bwe gusabigishwa.
Christ revealed his glory only to his disciples.
Ajya kumusozi gusenga.
He went on a big mountain to pray.
Aze arahinduranya.
And then there was transfiguration.
Ubwiza arambika ubwiza budasanzwe.
He got glory that
special. Yari kumwe na Petero, Yohana na Yakobo.
Peter, John and James.
Abonekerwa na Moses na Elia.
And then Moses and Elijah appeared.
Bamaze kumubonekera.
When they saw that
Petero arabibona.
Peter saw it.
They
saw him in a glory that he
didn't
know. When they saw him in that glory,
Peter
said, let's build three tents here.
We
saw Moses and Elijah. Let's build for them. Let's build for them and we stay here.
Jesus said,
no. Jesus said, no. Why was Elijah and Moses only who came? Why didn't Daniel come? And Daniel did great things. In that pit of the lion.
Why did
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego didn't come? And they passed through the tunnel of fire. Why only Moses and Elijah?
Harimam.
There's a reason. Let me tell
you.
They had a common base or common ground in the mission. Elijah, he came on the earth. He came with a purpose. At one point, God said, it's enough. You need to go home. And he told him to go home. When the fire has come down, then you tell me it's finished. I'm about to start the ministry.
And say
it's not. God put anoint Elisha and leave those people and you go. Moses,
now
him too.
He
came on earth with a mission. When he finished his mission, God took him on a mountain. So you see that country? The country where I showed you to take
people,
but you will not go there. It's enough. Now it's about to be, we are about to get to that country. We had problems here. Now it's about to get there. How can I get out? Jesus too. He came for something.
No, big it.
The blinds are
seeing. Time is up.
And the father said, time is up.
There's a time you need,
there's a place you need to get. That was the common ground they had. The second thing,
Joshua
was a disciple of Moses. Elisha was a disciple of Elijah. And Jesus, he had disciples. These people, they had what I call the apostolic anointing. They were in a certain anointing. Those type of people, they don't leave the earth without leaving disciples. And they just don't leave disciples like this. They leave them, giving them an inheritance. So that they may continue the work of the master. That's why Elijah
and Moses,
that's why they had to speak with Jesus. Let's talk about business. Let's tell you what we do. We've passed on this earth before you. These people, we know them. Let us tell you something. The Father sent us so that we speak with you. Another thing I tell you. Why didn't Elisha and Joshua didn't come? And yet they did even greater things than their masters. And they're the one who actually made to a fulfillment those works. Because in the vision, there is no child. Come again. In a vision, only the parents appear.
even if the child has done double of the father, in the revelation of the vision, the child appears. Only the father appears. That is why in that revelation that Christ had, Moses and Elijah only. Joshua didn't appear. Elisha did not appear. Let me tell you, my friends, those are the problems we have in churches in these times.
To be consoled.
Let's correct it.
There's
no two visions in the same home.
Vision iba imwe.
There's only one vision.
Kandi ugaragara muri vision n'umubyeyi.
And the one who appears is the parents.
Abana baba bari muri vision y'umubyeyi.
The children are part of that vision of the parents.
Kandi kukorera muri vision y'umubyeyi subuswa.
And working in the vision of the father is not being stupid.
Humura.
Don't even have a problem. You'll have the history will remember you. Even in the history they wrote about Joshua.
Turana musoma.
And we read about him.
But when it's about the vision, a son does not appear.
Those are the benefits.
Iruka, iruka, iruka. Turengi nyungu.
Let's go beyond the.
Turengi nyungu. Garukari akuri titre. How to become a disciple?
Yeah.
Ese ni gute umuna hinduka umu disciple nono.
How to become a disciple of Christ?
Muri kiraneza nonge kurasa minota mike ya turangis.
Follow me. I'm going to speak a few minutes and we finish.
Now
I'm about to land the
plane.
I'm
landing.
Listen properly.
Nigute nono duhindu kabigishwa.
And how to become a disciple of Christ.
Yesu Christ ari mu ijuru.
Christ is in heaven.
Nge ndi kwisi.
And I'm on this on earth. How can I become a disciple?
Ndashaka kubimenya nono.
Follow me now.
Ahakurikire.
Next.
Dore kiriya cyanditswe.
Look at that scripture.
Ibyakoze n'umwe gice cy'akabiri.
In Acts chapter 2.
Murongo wa 41 geza 42.
From 41 to 42.
Umva kila kyanze kuno kivuga.
Look at what the Bible says.
Nuko abeme ya magambo ye barabatizwa.
Then those who gladly received this word were baptized.
Bamaze kubatizwa.
And that day
hiyongera kubasanzwe abasanzwe nibande babigishwa bari basanzwe bahari.
On that day about 3000 souls were added to them.
Babigishwa ijana na 22 umuka wera wari wamanukiye kuko hano mu gice cy'akabiri umuka wera maze kumanuka.
We're talking about the 120 disciples because the Holy Spirit has just come down on them.
Ha yongera ibihumbi bitatu byabizera.
Was added to them another 3,000 of believers.
Kurikira neza ijambo ry'Imana ryarabwiwe imbaga y'abantu baje kureba icyabaye umunsi wa Pentecost.
The word of God was preached to those people, the crowd who came to listen to what
happened
on Pentecost. You follow and see how people change.
Umwuka wera waramanuke Petero n'abagenzi be bari 120 mu cyumba cy'amasengesho.
The Holy Spirit came down on 120 people, Peter and his friends went that. The crowd of Jerusalem came to see what happened. And Peter preached the good news. Because that's the tool that takes people from the crowd to believers. And the Bible speaks of about 3,000 men who were added. Who were added to the already existing disciples.
But they were
not yet disciples. Those are believers that were added to disciples. Look at how someone becomes a disciple. And the Bible says, they devoted themselves to the apostles' teachings. I want you to focus on that. They devoted themselves to the apostle teachings. Let me give you an answer to that question. How do we become a disciple? You become a disciple when you devote yourself, when you sit down, when you to follow the teaching of the apostles. You are transforming
Christ
by devoting yourself to the teaching of the apostles and also to submit to their leadership.
Follow me properly. I'm going to repeat it again. These people had believed. They had transformed into believers. And they became believers. For them to become the disciple like the others, there's something they did. Believing was not sufficient because they became saved. There's something else they added. They were devoted themselves to the preaching of the gospel. They took a decision to let go of their time. They sat and they got taught.
Now,
urambaza inunga ninde. Now you ask me who are the apostles. Who are the apostles? Well, who is the apostle? I want to answer to you.
Next.
Look at the definition of apostle.
This is a
definition
general.
It's a general definition.
Apostle is from the word in the Greek.
Comes from the word in the Greek.
Vita apostolos.
Apostolos.
Bivuzengo.
Which means.
Uoherejwe.
One who is sent,
Umufugizi.
A messenger,
Useruki.
An ambassador.
Inego yupo koerezwa.
The purpose of sending
Nugutanga ubutunga
runaka is to convey a certain
message.
The one who is sent,
iyo nyuma yo kwizera,
after believing,
wicaye
ku birenge bye. You sit at his
feet. Ukigishwa nawe.
You are taught by him.
Ugatozwa nawe.
You are trained by him.
Ukiyashishikara kukurikira inyigisho ze.
You decide to follow the teaching.
Icyo nicyo kiguhindura kuba umwigisha wa Yesu.
This is what changes us to become disciples.
Because
those words and those
things,
they will build in you a character of Christ.
Next.
And look at that scripture. In Luke 6:13, and when it was day, he called his disciples to himself.
Atoranyamo cumi na babiri abita intumwa.
And from them he chose 12 whom he also named apostles.
Ndashaka kubona ijambo umwigishwa urebe n'intumwa hano.
You see the word disciple and the word apostle.
Abigishwa bari benshi.
The disciples were many.
Ariko intumwa zari cumi n'ebyiri.
But the apostles were 12.
Kuko
because
Kristo akura intumwa mu bigishwa.
Christ takes the apostle from the disciples.
He creates
apostles from the disciples group.
You
cannot be an apostle without having a disciple. You see the context of Jesus? He had a disciple. And he took 12 of them. He named them apostles. He took them from the disciples. And he gave them a new role. Gives them a special mission.
Now, next.
An apostle,
numwigishwa,
he is a disciple,
woherejwe na Kristo,
sent by Christ,
kumuserukira,
with a specific mandate.
Umushingano runaka.
With a specific mandate.
Reka mbikwerekere.
Let me show you.
Turi muri Evangelical Restoration Church.
Church. I want to bring this in the context of our church.
Muri ERC.
We are in ERC.
Muri ERC.
In ERC.
Nyoboye parosa Gikondo.
I lead Gikondo Parish.
But I'm not an apostle.
You know why?
I'm just a disciple.
He's a disciple.
Dore aho rero ntandukaniye n'intumwa.
Look at where it's different with the apostle.
Intumwa yavuga ijambo nanye ngarivuga.
Is because even if the apostle can speak and I can also speak.
Nubwo intumwa yabwiriza abantu bagakizwa nanye nabwiriza abantu bagakizwa.
The apostle can preach people get saved and I can preach people get saved.
Kurikira neza iki kintu.
Follow well this I'm saying.
Intumwa,
the apostle,
numwigishwa,
is a disciple.
Wakuwe mubigishwa,
was taken away from
the disciple. Ahabwa ishingano runaka.
And received a special mission.
Muri ERC.
That's a root.
Ntacyo nabwiwe n'Imana kuri uyu murimo.
In ERC, there's nothing God told me. God told me nothing in this.
Ariko ifite uwo yakuye mu bigishwa.
But he had someone that he took from the disciples and he made him an apostle.
amukura mu bigisho amugira intumwa ayoherezwa n'inshingano runaka
and he sent him with a special mission
genda mu Rwanda
go in Rwanda
usana abanyarwanda
and restore the land
iyo niyo nshingano
that's a mission
tabongereza bita the mandate
yonge nishinga the mandate
ahabwa inshingano
he got the mandate
nge na unahawe
I got none
no
There's nothing that was told.
Nubwo hari andigikon.
Even if as then and then
it told. Ndiyai mugakiza.
There are children that are my
Ariko
children.
Na mandate na hawi.
But there is no mandate.
Kubijani na mission ya ERC, I don't have the mandate.
About the ERC mission, sindiwai inshinga.
Ahubwo icyo nkora ni kingiki.
But what I do is this.
I've been assigned by the apostle.
Bama inshinga, apostle no ama inshinga.
Kugira ngo nkorere ya mission.
So that I work in that mission in a special place.
This
is what Jesus said.
He
had many disciples. And he had
12.
And sent them in a special mandate. And he called them apostles. And that apostle to whom Christ gave, when you've believed, you go and
see
that you speak. And you listen to the speech.
When you do that, you become a true disciple. Now. No, she didn't ask.
Let me land now.
Moses,
at the church. His church was called
Evangelical Liberation Church.
It was called Evangelical Liberation Church. Because the mandate that he had, it was to liberate his people. To take people from slavery and
Joshua.
And Joshua, he was a disciple. Because God has not taken apostle among
Moses.
And Moses finished his mandate. God took among the disciples. Because it has not taken apostle among others but the disciples.
He
didn't take Aaron.
He
didn't take Uri.
He
took Joshua.
Because he was a true disciple.
He was sitting at the feet
of Moses.
He had believed. He knew that he had a
mandate.
And they had the right
mandate.
God gave him the mandate too.
Was the mandate of Joshua?
You know the mandate of Joshua? Here's the church of Joshua.
Evangelical Establishment Church.
This is what we call apostolic.
Moses was
working apostolic anointing.
Joshua
also worked in apostolic anointing. Those people with mandates, those are the ones we call apostles.
Lero bibilia vuga ngo nushaka kubi umwigi kwa nyawe.
The Bible says you want to be a
teacher. And
devote yourself to the teaching of the apostle. The apostle is not just any person.
They
see people who give the church the name. The hand of the God. The ear of the Lord. The knees of the Lord church. The back of the Lord church. What is the source of that?
The name of a church goes with
the mandate that the apostle received. Because the name goes for the mandate that the man of God received.
Samson Chachi Yarikita. Chachi Samson.
What's the name of the church of
Samson? It's Liberation Church.
Because the mandate that you receive, it gives you is the meaning to the church. People just do church the way they want. It's not game. It's not just about names. It's not about they don't accept me. I'm going to do my church.
Which mandate have you? Oh,
which one?
No,
I want to preach.
I
need to preach to the people.
How do you get
that? That's not the way it works. Go read the word the Bible says. It took
12
of the disciples and made them apostles. And the rest stayed. Those were disciples.
And
they worked within the mandate of the 12.
The ERC,
myself,
the disciples.
I'm a disciple.
Even if I'm a pastor,
I'm a disciple.
Church. I work
to the one who got the mandate. God has never told me to start the church.
For your information, let
me tell you. God never told me to start the church in Kikondo. What he told me, my son, you wrote the church. I want you. I didn't know when. I didn't know how. Because in the plan of God, there are people God has put aside to serve others. That's the way it works. That's how it works. Even in heaven they know. Agar was about to refuse it. When she saw that she was pregnant, she despised the master and she ran away. When she ran away, the angel found her sitting on the
throne.
So Agar, where are you going? What's happening?
What's
happening? I have problems with my bones, I have problems. This is what the angel said.
Agari umujakazi wa Sara.
The angel called her Aga, the servant of Sarah.
Oh?
Even in heaven they know that I'm the servant of Sarah.
Oh. No.
Man, je unarizi uko ari ibintu byo kwisi?
I thought these are things here on earth.
No, the
servanthood is down here.
No,
I want my independence.
No,
you in heaven don't enter that business. Here on earth, these are our things. And the angel said,
Agari mujakazi wa Sara.
Agar, the servant of Sara.
Urabae, urajani.
Where are you coming? Where are you going?
Subirayo uganduke musiki gaza chanyoko buja.
Go back and be faithful under the hand of your master.
Joshua, gice cya mbere.
Joshua 1.
Umurongo wa mbere.
1.
Bibiliya avuga ngo,
the Bible says,
nyuma y'urupfu rwa Mose,
after the death of Moses,
umugaragu w'Iteka,
the servant of God,
abimana ireba nk'abagaragu be,
those that God see as his servants, God called them the servants,
intumwa yahaye mandate,
the apostle received a mandate,
nabo bariportinga mbere ye,
those are the ones who report
the count of the land,
they have reports to give to God.
Imana nishaka kubaza ERC nakwizaza kubaza Pastor Patrick.
If God wants to ask about ERC,
Never.
He will talk to the one who gave the mandate to restore on this.
He told Joshua,
Moses, my servant, has died. Stand up, you, the servant of Moses.
Men, no. No. Njewe nagiye kurwana intambara nyinshi Mose ari yari yicaye yiryamire ku musozi asenga. Njewe
I was fighting those battles and Moses was just on the mountain. Me, how do you call me?
Njewe butumanyigisha uriya mugabo yabwigisha.
The teaching that can give and that old man gives.
Unyita mukozi.
And you call me his servant.
Mose mugaragwa. Joshua mugaragwa Mose.
Joshua the servant.
Mugaragwa wange yakuye.
My servant has died.
Mandate yarangi.
The mandate is over.
No, wowe.
And now you.
Ukona kubonye kwaba yumwigisha.
Because I've seen that you've been no,
no,
disciple. I'm going to make you the apostle.
Inuma na wali bagrad. Abantu bari kubira. Jeho nasenge yobisa ubuno nje kusengerwa apostle. It's not like that. It's not like that. Abantu kubigenda.
Being apostle is not just
Abari masina.
Okay, now you are calling yourself an apostle. What did God tell you about
nations?
What did God tell you about nations?
Now,
You'll be a disciple of Jesus. How is a disciple of the
person?
And see the link with Jesus Christ. In Matthew 28, from 18 to 20, he told the apostle, go and make all nations my disciples. Those people, where they will meet with me, where they will be my disciples. Because on earth they have been your disciples. Because what you teach them is not yours. Teach them what I have taught you. Because if they receive what I've taught them, they receive my character. Those are the teachings of the apostles that we need to go and learn. Because they receive them from Christ, and they deliver them to us, they give us the divine nature that they receive. And it changes us to resemble Jesus Christ. If you don't want to be a disciple of a man, you'll never be a disciple of Jesus. If you don't want to become a disciple of a person, of a man, you'll never be a disciple of Jesus. Because he does that work with the people to whom he gets the mandate to represent him. And this, the church, you need to understand. That's why when the father said, this year we're going to change. Now you also look in that direction. Go in that direction. Stay in that teaching. Sit in that teaching. Did I tell you a new thing this week?
I'm preaching the mandate.
I didn't tell you anything.
I'm preaching the message of my apostle.
The apostle is
an announcement. This is his teaching.
An announcement.
Dying is his teaching. Obedience is speaking. I'm not preaching something new. I'm implementing the mandate. How can you walk in your things?
They make you a pastor in a few days to just go do your own things.
Do your things,
your own vision, you're doing your own things. And you believe that you're in the church, you're in the family. You need to change it.
And I'm talking to my friends, young people. We need to change this thing. We need to change our mindset. We need to set our mind.
We need
to put right things at the right place.
Jesus,
generation.
If you understand and follow these things,
the church in 10 years will be the unshakable organization.
But if we miss that point, we will not be different than the former generation.
The apostle.
When you sit next to him, learn what he says.
What are you teaching?
Learn what he says and teach and stay in that teaching. Pastor Ginasare told us here. I look at you here, and you have a pastor, an apostle like this one, and you are still looking for other teachings. Why don't you just listen to what he
says?
His son teaches different things here in the overnight. Did he teach something
different?
He took the book of the father and
did you see the anointing
here? Did you see the anointing here? Let me tell you.
teaching what you receive is another wisdom. Being able to give what you receive is not being stupid. It's wisdom. It's what people don't understand. Paul said, what I told you, what you heard, what you see me do, give to other people. Who are capable to give what you
receive?
It requires capacity. Who are capable to give to others?
Get
out of the believer group and start listening to what this man of God is teaching. Sit there. Just sit. Follow. Put in action. Continue. Look at him. That is how Elisha was doing for with Elijah. When God sees that heart,
he
gets to a point where he trusts you and takes you from the believers to become a disciple. You see this parent of ours, apostle, when his time is arrived, God will not allow anyone who is not a disciple to be lifted up. It can't happen. Even if people it do not work. Because God will take the apostles from the disciples only. Let's stand up and pray.
Maze turememo mwami abushaka kutugirabo uyu mukigitondo niburi hano tarakira Yesu Kristo.
If you are here this morning, not that you see Jesus Christ,
sinarangiza naragwa mayirwe.
I can't give you
the
opportunity.
Wowe utarakira Yesu Kristo.
You've never received Jesus Christ.
Ndakwinginze ikindi gitondo cyawe.
This is your morning.
Yesu Kristo aragukunda.
Jesus Christ.
Yesu Kristo aragushaka.
Jesus wants you.
Uyu ni musogo uhinduka kwawe.
Today is your day of change.
Ngwino usange, ngwino hauri.
Come in front.
Wamanu kukaza tukagufasha.
You can come and we'll
pray. Woshaka kwihana ibyaha byawe.
If you want to change.
Ikigitondo Kristo araguhamagaye.
This morning
Christ aragushaka.
He wants to change your life. Can we see if you want to change your life and give your life to Christ?
Yes, Oragushaka.
Jesus wants you.
Yes, Oragushaka.
Jesus wants you.
Manukunze usange.
You can come down.
Uyu munsi wagakiza.
Today is a day of salvation. Today is a day of grace.
Bikore.
Do it.
Mwizina rya Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Ndabona twese twarahaye ubuzima bwacu Kristo.
I see we are all born again.
Dushimire Imana.
Let's thank the Lord.
Mana data ndagushimiye.
Father God, we thank you.
Urakoze kuba bana bawe.
We thank you for
Mbatu yumugisha wawo.
And I speak
ineza yao
and your grace
nubundu bwao
and your grace
nimbabazi zao
and your favor
zitarondoreka
on
zijane na buru wese
may go with each one of
tujye kunyura hose
wherever we go
mwizina rya Yesu Kristo
in the name of Jesus Christ
amen
amen
urakoze cyane.